Hi, I'm Ollie Hooper, a quantitative developer at QuantConnect, and this is Idea Streams, a weekly video series where we test an idea derived from current market trends by building a training strategy on QuantConnect. In this week's Idea Streams, we're going to be addressing Bitcoin, and we're going to be looking at how we're going to enter a market at such all-time highs and during such periods of volatility. So let's first have a look at the actual Bitcoin chart here, and we can see over the last part of 2020 following into 2021 there was a huge rise in the price of Bitcoin. There's been a bit of consolidation since then, but the trading strategy that we're going to be employing today is dollar cost averaging, and what this will do is it will minimize the volatility and the impact of investing in assets such as Bitcoin by investing over a period of time. So let's jump into a fresh algorithm, and the first thing that we're going to address is the depositing of cash. So simulating depositing, for example, $10 a week into our account. So we can get rid of this, and we can get rid of this on data function here. And the first thing that we want to do is actually schedule a deposit method. So we're going to do self.schedule.on, and then we're going to use the various date rules and time rules that we get to schedule the method. So if we go into the algorithm reference, down to scheduled events, we can see these date time rules and then these time rules. Okay, so here's an example here. We've got date rules. So this is on a specific date and then at 1 o'clock. So we want to do it every week. So we're going to be using self.daterules.every day of the week Monday. So let's copy and paste that in. And now we want a time rule. So we want it, let's say, at 12 o'clock every day. So let's just grab this one, paste that in, and replace that with 12 o'clock. And then we need to provide the method itself. So let's call this deposit. And then we finish that off. So now let's create that deposit method. So deposit, and let's drop in self. And what we want to use here is the portfolio cash book. So this is going to, this cash book is basically the cash that you have in your account. So we want to add $10 each week to that cash book, simulating investing $10 into our trading account. So self.portfolio.cashbook, and we want the dollar amount. And we're just going to add an amount here of $10. There you go, simple as that. So now if we set that cash as $10 and start this in 2017, for example, we will simply see $10 being invested each week and just a straight line going up. So let's backtest this and have a look if that is actually what happens. So yes, as we can see, that is exactly what happens. This is just $10 each week going into our trading account. Okay, now let's move into the next step and actually invest in Bitcoin. So this is going to be pure dollar cost averaging over the period, $10 a week going into Bitcoin. So all we need to do for that is we need to add our Bitcoin to our algorithm. So we're going to use add crypto instead of add equity and give it the Bitcoin USD pair. And let's set this to a resolution of daily. And we'll take the symbol from that and save it as self.btc. There we go. So all we're going to do here now is just do a set holdings of our entire portfolio in Bitcoin, just like that. So now we should see what it looks like if we invested $10 each week from 2017 into Bitcoin. So let's backtest this now. Great, and here we can see that it has run. So you can see that it magnifies the returns as we get further along, as we've obviously built up more and more capital. Okay, so we've looked at a very basic dollar cost averaging algorithm here, but now let's add an extra step to it and add a bit of a strategy to it. So let's have a look at using a 52-week high indicator to initiate a period of dollar cost averaging. So what we're going to do with our next strategy is we're actually going to look to see if there's been a new 52-week high. If this 52-week high is greater than our previous 52-week high, then we're going to enter a period of 6 months of dollar cost averaging investing into Bitcoin. So all the while we're still putting that $10 each week into our trading account, but only during this 6 month period are we actually investing that into Bitcoin. So all we need to do for that is then just add a catch around the set holdings. And first, we need to actually have this 52 week high indicator. So let's call this self.max. And we're going to use the self.max functionality here, this indicator. We're going to give it Bitcoin, and we're going to give, say, 365 days. We want a record of the previous high. So let's just start this as -1. Okay, so as I said before, remember each week we're still adding that $10, but this time we're only going to invest into Bitcoin if there's been a new 52 week high. So let's say if self.high is less than self.max and its current value, so remember this is an indicator, then we're going to set self.high to be the current value of that 52 week high. And we're also going to set an end date for this 6 month period of dollar cost averaging. So self.stop investing, and we're going to take our current time plus a time delta of 182 days. So this means that we can actually use this stop investing time to check whether we should actually be investing in Bitcoin. So down here, if the current time is within this investing period, so if it's before stop investing, then we want to be setting our holdings to be fully Bitcoin. Okay, so now let's have a look at what this has added to our algorithm. Here we go, and we can see that our algorithm has performed similarly to before, but if we check the orders and go to the last page, we'll see that we're currently in a period of investing into Bitcoin, so that 6 month period. But the last time before that was actually at the beginning of 2018. So mid-2018, that's when we stopped our last period of dollar cost averaging, and there hasn't actually been a higher 52-week high until the 7th of December 2020. So we can see that our algorithm is working as we expected. So we don't actually know how much money we have actually invested over this period of time. We don't know whether this 15K is how much we've invested. We haven't actually made anything, or we don't know whether we've only invested £100. I mean, we can do the calculations just by counting the number of weeks, but it would be nice to visualize this on this graph. So we can do that by just having a variable called self.invested, which is just going to keep track of this. So when we add $10 to our dollar cash book, we can just add $10 to this variable as well. And we can plot this variable on the same chart as the strategy equity, and this will allow us to view, it should just be a straight line of $10 every week as we saw in the first backtest that we ran. So here we go, self.plot, strategy, equity, and we'll call this one amount invested. And this will just plot that invested variable. Great, so let's run a backtest for this now. Perfect, so we can see that the backtest ran again, and this time we've actually got this amount invested line on our graph. So we can see what the sort of active performance looks like. We can see that actually around early 2019, we were kind of nearly hitting the nominal amount that we had actually just invested, but obviously, as we're investing periodically, the nominal value of the investment builds up, and so we start seeing greater increases in our portfolio. So with all of that in mind, I hope you now have a better idea of how to incorporate dollar cost averaging into your strategy, how to use the cash book to simulate depositing money into your trading accounts at regular intervals using the scheduling events, and also how to use crypto. If you'd like clarification on any of these points or have any questions in general, please do not hesitate to reach out. Both the team here at Quant Connect, as well as the whole Quant community, are very valuable resources. And if you'd like to put an idea similar to this or any other idea to the test, check out Quant League, a weekly rolling competition where the quants in the community put their alphas to the test to win a share of a $1,000 cash prize pool. See if you can win with your algo. Until next time, happy coding.